The Economic Offences Wing of the Mumbai Police, the Income Tax and the Enforcement Directorate have begun a multi-agency probe against Yash Birla and its 24 companies for allegedly duping its investors and siphoning money abroad. Now, as the investigation is progressing, more and more evidence of the alleged fraud is being revealed.
Industrialist and fitness enthusiast, the head of a 3,000 crore group, Yash Birla, now finds his business dealings the subject of an investigation. This after the Economic Offences Wing of the Mumbai Police filed an FIR against the Yash Birla company for allegedly defaulting in repayments of fixed deposits to investors.
Yes, we have registered a criminal case based on the complaint of certain investors who have invested on a term fixed deposit scheme in Birla Power Solutions Private Limited. And it was a term deposit whereby they were supposed to be given a fixed return. And when the term expired, the principal amount was also lost and no interest was also given.
So far, 28 investors have come forward and filed a complaint against the company, claiming they have not received their money from the fixed deposit scheme floated by a subsidiary of the Yash Birla Group. The EOW has now filed an FIR with Yash Birla as the first accused.
We have frozen the bank accounts and we are examining the book of accounts, and we have found out that in a very systematic manner, some of the directors have excused themselves from the board of directors, and probably they were aware that this particular business model was not a business model which was going to be successful, and the investors have been cheated. He is the name accused in the FIR by the complainants, and definitely as the complaint goes, the investigation is in progress. The sections of cheating of Indian Penal Code has been applied in this case.
Documents in possession of the Economic Offences Wing suggest that the money collected from the investors might have been siphoned off to a city in Middle East. While the investigation is on to establish the money trail, the EOW has already written to the Central Fraud Monitoring Cell in Bangalore, asking them to inform all the banks under their umbrella to immediately debit freeze all the accounts of Birla Power Solutions, its subsidiary companies, its associate companies, as well as its sister concerns. The investors who approached the police alleged that they were forced to do so after the group allegedly stopped responding to them.
We approached them again after a couple of months. We sent them three or four reminders, no response at all from their side. We sent them a legal notice and again there was no response. We've sent our representatives to their companies. Again, they said, no, we are in trouble. We can't refund any money.
Though I have tried to contact him on phone, on by email, by SMS, sometimes he has replied, sometimes he has not replied. But in his reply, he has never mentioned how he'll give back the money. And when I go to his offices, I really feel crying myself. In the sense, there are a lot of senior citizens coming to his office for 10,000 and 20,000, which they have given as a fixed deposit, and they have not been attended properly.
Yash Birla's group has been the subject of an ongoing investigation of both the Enforcement Directorate and the Income Tax Investigation Wing. And with the EOW also opening its case, the group will need to come clear on all the allegations it faces.
Times Now had written to Yash Birla on 15th of January asking him to clarify on the allegations against him or even to send us a formal statement on the FIR registered. It's been more than a week and we are still awaiting a response. In Mumbai, Megha Prasad for Times Now.